Hello everyone, this is Jan Chromý and together we will continue the course Interdisciplinary Approaches to Language and its Use. In this presentation we will introduce a new topic in our discussion of psycholinguistics, namely the study of bilingualism. People typically know more than only their native language. Etymologically speaking, bilingualism means the knowledge of two languages, but in psycholinguistics and other fields, people who know more than one language are commonly called bilinguals. In this course, we will therefore use bilingualism as a general term for the knowledge of more than one language. Nevertheless, speakers differ in the number of languages they are able to use, and this is obviously important for the language processing and acquisition. However, there are other important differences. For example, the level of knowledge of the languages. One language may be dominant and better known, but there are also cases of the so-called balanced bilingualism, when the two languages are acquired on the level of a native speaker. Receptive bilingualism is also distinguished, and it refers to the passive knowledge. Receptive bilinguals understand another language, but they cannot use it. Important thing is, when did the speaker start to learn the languages? We distinguish between simultaneous bilingualism, which is a situation when the two or more languages are learned since birth, and successive bilingualism, when the other languages start to be acquired later. Languages can be acquired in various settings, either implicitly in real-life situations or explicitly in a tutored fashion, such as in schools. Very important for the psycholinguistic research are the differences between languages. They can be relatively small, such as between Czech and Polish or between English and French, but they can be very big, such as between English and Japanese, for example. The last important factor is the environment. The languages may be used frequently in the environment of the speaker, or they may be foreign languages, which are generally not used in the locale of the speaker. In sum, there are many differences between various bilinguals, most of them quite obvious. Research on bilingualism is thus very hard because it is problematic to construct a meaningful sample, and the generalizations of the results may be either doubtful or valid only for a very specific subset of speakers. There are various domains of research in psycholinguistics of bilingualism. In the further presentation, we will focus on bilingual acquisition, on the interdependence between the first and second language, and also on the cognitive aspects of bilingualism. Before we will conclude this presentation, I have one reading tip for you. If you would like to get a deeper understanding of the research in the domain of bilingualism, you should read the book Psycholinguistics of Bilingualism by François Grosjean and Pink Lee. If you enjoy the presentations, we would be glad if you would like them on YouTube. That is all from me now. See you next time.